Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernard from the BTNHD, and today is all about upgrading our Smart Deploy to version 2.0.3080. So let's get right into it. Okay, so deploying Smart Deploy is super simple, and first thing that we need to do with any upgrade that we do, make sure if you're running it with a virtual machine or a physical machine, back it up or take a snapshot or take a checkpoint. Because I'm running my Smart Deploy within Hyper-V Manager, I'm going to right-click on it and then go into Checkpoint to create a checkpoint. In case something happens, I am able to go back in time into a nice, stable environment. Once that's completed, make sure underneath the checkpoint section, it says, you know, you have a checkpoint to go back. That's always a good thing. Within my Smart Deploy server, I went inside Control Panel, Programs and Features, and I want to show you guys that I'm running 3070 and we need to upgrade it to 3080. From my understanding, it looks like 3080 supports Windows 10 2004, and that is something that I want to deploy within my environment. Now, before we continue, it looks like I also have Windows ADK version 18.3.6.2. This version does not support Windows 10 2004, so I'm crossing my fingers that Smart Deploy will actually see it and upgrade it for us. Within the MDT and the SCCM world, when you're deploying a new version for those deployment services, they don't upgrade your ADK automatically for you, so you have to do it manually. So I'm crossing my fingers that Smart Deploy is smart enough to do that for us. So the first thing we need to do is log into our smartdeploy.com account, and you got a big button that says download. You can click on the release notes to get more information on what's new with this version. So I'm going to click on download now. It's going to start downloading. It's around 1.3 gigs. Once it's completed, I am going to click on the nice little arrow, show in folder. I'm going to right click on that exe file and then run it as an administrator. It's going to start preparing the installation. Once the installation is prepared, you're going to get this. I'm going to click next here, accept the license and terms, click next, install. It's going to start validating the install and you're done. Click on finish and it's going to automatically start your Smart Deploy console, which is awesome. Now let's go back inside the control panel. And as you can see, Smart Deploy was upgraded to 2.0.3080. Awesome. But our Windows ADK was not updated. Ah, why? Ugh. So what we need to do is we have to manually upgrade it. So go inside your favorite website. I will provide this link at the bottom of the comic section. And just download your Windows ADK and your Windows PE. Once you download the files that you need that will support Windows 10 version 2004, go back inside the control panel, programs and features, and you have to manually remove everything. So I'm going to select the Windows ADK. I'm going to click on uninstall. I'm going to hit yes here, uninstalling the features, and you're done. And then click on close and do the same thing with the Windows PE. Click on uninstall, hit yes. It's going to start uninstalling all the features and you're done. Click close. From here, you're going to open up your downloads folder or wherever you drop those ADK files. And I'm going to right click on the ADK setup file first, click next here, pick your poison and accept the license and terms, install, boom, done. Do the same thing with the Windows PE, double click on it. It's going to launch up, click next here, pick your answer, click next, accept the license and terms. You only have one feature, click install. It's going to start installing all the features and you're done. Close it. Bam. When you go back inside programs and features, you're going to see that your Windows ADK and your Windows PE was upgraded to 19.0.4.1, which supports Windows 10 version 2004. That's a good thing. Now, the only thing I like about Smart Deploy is that it will automatically upgrade the clients for you. That is awesome. Right now, I'm logged into BTNHD SD1. This machine actually has the Smart Deploy client. When I went inside programs and features to look at the client, it automatically was updated. So that is a good thing. I like that. That once you upgrade your Smart Deploy server, it will automatically go out to your computers within your infrastructure that has the Smart Deploy client and will upgrade the client for you automatically. It'd have been awesome if Windows ADK was automatically updated for you during the upgrade of the server, right? And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that like button. Also, do not forget about punch, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out. Before you head out, make sure to sign up and get your free subscription to manage 15 machines forever at smartdeploy.com/BTNHD.